So in this three to four diagrams, I tried to explain the various terms here. First one, this is the fillet weld. This is the lap of fillet weld because two plates are overlapped here. This is the T type of junction. We have welded it from both sides, left and right. In this third diagram here, you can see weld in a 90 degree. That is a perpendicular weld. For this perpendicular weld, we have used the round shape of weld. In that, we got this effective throat thickness, that is small t, ETT. The formula to find the ETT is 0.7 multiplied by size of weld. Size of weld, you will get it projected here. This is the size of weld. Okay. Now, as it is symmetrical, you can also call this as, this is also the size of weld. It is similar to this. Okay. Now, based on the size of weld, your length of weld is decided. And your length of weld is, here you can see, L actual and L effective. L actual is the actual length of weld that you use on the site. That is 6 times of the size of weld. Whereas L effective is the 4 times of size of weld, which is as per your design on your paper. So the paperwork is different and actual your work on the site, on the field is different. So the difference is what? This 2 times of S is the difference. So again, we can write a formula, that is L actual is equal to L effective plus 2S. So this you can, this formula you can write from this condition. So ultimately we got this formula. That is the design strength of fillet weld. This formula is there. Ultimate strength, you can assume it as 410 megapascal divided by root 3 multiplied by sigma mw. That is the partial factor of safety for the weld. It is having the two types. 1.25 if you weld it in shop, 1.5 if you weld it on site. Shop means workshop, field means on site. Okay, so this is the difference. Now one more term is there, and that one more term is the your angle of weld. Okay, so how you can find the angle now? I will again draw one diagram. Now this is the angle. This is the angle of weld. Okay, now how much should be this angle? This angle should be from 60 degree to 120 degree. 60 to 120 should be the range of this angle of weld. This is called as the angle of weld. Angle of weld. So this is all related with the fillet weld. Everything is given here for the fillet weld. Now the effective throat thickness having the formula 0.7 multiplied by S is the generalized formula. Okay, the actual formula is K multiplied by S. Okay, so ETT is equal to K multiplied by S. So the value of K, how you will find the value of K, that is important. This is the last point as far as the fillet weld is considered. So this value will depend from K is equal to 0.55. to 0.70. And it is derived from the table. Table number 22 from the IS 800-2007. Now, again, one more thing is there, that is the S minimum and S max. How much will be the maximum size of weld and how much can be the minimum size of weld? That thing we also need to find. So S minimum and S maximum. S minimum will be depend on the table number 21. S minimum will be dependent on the table number 21, while as the S maximum, the formula you will have, the two formulas are there, that is the T minimum, that is the minimum thickness minus 1.5 mm, that is the thickness of plate. T minimum is thickness of plate, and second formula is 3/4 of the T minimum. 3/4 multiplied by T minimum. T minimum is minimum thickness of the cover plate or any plate that you are going to weld. Okay, so now this is complete information about the your fillet weld. Everything is mentioned here about the fillet weld. If you take the, what you can say, screenshot of this, then you will get the all information regarding this fillet weld. Okay, so I hope that you got everything about the fillet weld, and we can also able to solve the numerical based on this fillet weld. The two more types are there. One is the plug weld is there, then slot weld is there, then plug weld is there. Okay, now what is the slot weld? I will explain it in short. What is the plug weld? That also I can explain it in short. Now, if these two plates are there, suppose that these two plates are there, you create a hole in this. You create hole, and that hole will be your plug, and you weld it. So that type of weld is known as the plug weld. Okay, and the last type is your slot weld. What is meant by the slot weld? If this is in top view, this is first plate. In top view, if this is first plate, and this is now second weld, second plate. Okay, now what happens here? You create a slot here, such type of slot, and after that you weld it. After that you weld it. Okay, so this will be your slot weld. Okay, so now you got the plug weld also, you got the slot weld also, these two welds you got. So now all types of welds we got completed. This was our second type, fillet weld. First type was the groove weld, second type is fillet weld, third type is plug weld, and fourth type is slot weld. Okay, so mostly we use the fillet weld. So that's why fillet weld is having so much specifications. We are going to solve the numericals based on this fillet weld also. That is also requirement as per our syllabus. Okay, so I hope that you got it. One more thing is remaining. Only one single thing is remaining, and that is about the your square weld and what is the round weld. Okay, now I will just explain you it in very short. What is the difference? Now you can see here. Now if this type of welding is done here in a round shape, then this is a round shape of weld. Okay, but if the weld is done in a square shape, then this is a square shape of fillet weld. This was the only point remaining in case of the welded connection. Okay, so now at last we got everything here. This is all about the welded connection. We have seen these types, and in our next lecture, we will see the numericals based on your welded connection.